Hi guys. Okay, so today is day 4 of Road to GM. Alright, so this is the end game I learned today. Alright, so before I analyze the game, so alright, I'm still using the same book by the way. So yeah, same book. So in the start of the game, right, the author of this book, Mark Doretsky, who played the back pieces here, right, he say, "I do not choose the strongest plan," right, and he show a dialogue. "Tell me please, where should I go from here? That depends on where you want to be," by Lewis Carroll. Right, so you'll see later what he mean. Right, so in this position, right, black is up 2 pawn. Right, black is up 2 pawn, but right, as you can see, there's three triple isolated pawn here. So maybe white could save the game. Alright, so white in this position, white played the obvious move, which is a takes b5. Alright, and the following variation seems to be forced, right, which is a takes b5. And now, okay, you can't take the pawn, because we can go rook d1 check, and then your king might have been some problem, you know. There's some check here and check here after king h2. Your king is just too weak. Right, because all of your two pieces is just after queen takes, and then your king is just too weak because your queen and rook is on the queen side. They can't defend the king. So this position, the good move for white is rook a1. The idea is now you want to play queen takes b5. You stop rook d1 check. Another idea is you want to go rook e1, right, and start collect this pawn. But now black has a very good move, which is rook d3, cut the king queen diagonal, and the idea is after rook e1, now we go e3. So instead of, you know, there's a weak triple pawn here, instead of just give them this semi-open file, we just give up a pawn, but we block the file, right, block the open file, and after e4, black is still up a pawn, right, still up a pawn, and he has kingside maturity. So the idea is very simple, he just want to advance his kingside pawn. Right, the position of the king maybe will be less secure, right, and maybe opponent will get definite tactical counter chances. However, black has every reason for counting on success. Right, so in this position, so the team of Doretsky found a very nice move here. Right, so instead of takes, he find another possibility here. So the idea is after we takes, the rook can go back. So they want to go e3 in this position. Why? So now the idea is the rook can't go back, and maybe it's just easier for us, for black pieces, to exploit, right, the king, the weak king here. Alright, so in this position, white has to choose between f takes e3 and queen takes e3. Alright, and then you might ask, white rook takes a6 doesn't work here. Right, rook takes a6 actually loses. Okay, the book actually, they say queen takes f2 was the move here. But, you know, I guess that time, you know, there's no engine, so actually queen takes f2 was not the best move here. So, according to engine, queen b1 is the right move after king h2. Now we go rook d1. And now you can see this king is just too weak. Now there's some check here. So let's say rook takes e6. The simplest way is just rook h1 check here, and then queen f5, threatening mate in 1 and threatens the rook. Right, you can also play some queen e4 after take, check, take the f pawn, and then check. You win the queen. Or let's say after takes, check here. And takes, and you can check on g1 or check on f4, which is totally winning. So in this position, instead of rook take e6, let's say to take on e3. Okay, rook h1 check, and queen g6 check. Now you have this check, and then simply rook h4. Now you threaten again mate in 1. Right, you also threaten some rook f4 check, king e2, rook e4. You know, just completely winning. But okay, let's say in the book, you know, that time there's no engine. In the book, they say queen takes f2 was the winning move. Right, but in fact, they miss one move for white pieces. So the idea is after takes, we go check here and e2. Alright, and the book says, you know, it's just winning for black. Right? Yeah, it seems like just winning for black because now the threat is just take the queen and promote. If you take our rook, then we take. And, you know, we are just up a queen. Yeah, it's queen against rook. So this position white has a very nice defense here. So you can pause the video if you want. It's white to play here. Yeah, so the move is actually queen e1. Instead of let him promote, we just play queen e1, block the square of the e1 square because the pawn wants to promote the next move. Now we're clicking f2. So you have to move the rook and we just take the pawn. And maybe white can hold a draw something, but obviously black still have some chances there. Right, some great winning chances. You know, so rook takes a6 is definitely losing. Alright, so first let's look at f takes e3. Alright, now right, you can see the idea of e3. Now the rook is not defending the king. So now actually queen b1 is actually better for black. Right? After king h2, rook d1. And now to counter attack, queen g4 here is insufficient because of rook h1 check, king g3, and queen e1 check, king f3, rook f1, king e4, and now rook f4. Now it's a fork. We're forking the king and the queen. You can't take because it's a pin, and now we just win the game. Black just win the game. Right, so this doesn't work. Right, it's actually one move away from checkmate, but unfortunately your king is just too weak. So in this position, right, so you might ask, does black have a serious threat? So let's try. If let's say b6 play, check, king here, and now queen e4 is not the right move because now there's queen g4. They force a queen trade and then at the same time the threatens checkmates. Of course you don't trade the queen. Queen takes d3. Again they force a queen trade. Queen trade. Queen e1. Queen f2. Queen e4. Now there's this good move. Queen f6. And black has to give perpetual check. So after rook h1, king g3, now black have to play this move, right, to stop queen g4. So the move is h5. Alright, so after h5, alright, let's say b7, now we go queen e4, king f2, alright, because we just simply threatens checkmate. Here queen h4 checks anyway, g2, and now rook h2 check. Right, queen h2, it's also fine, but rook h2 is actually better, right, because in this position here e4 takes, and white promotes the queen. So rook h2 check, king f1, and now we go queen h3 check, and you can see, so next move is just gonna take the queen. We check. King e1, we just take the queen, we check. If king g1 takes, I believe we have checkmate here. After the promote, rook e1 check, king f2, queen f1 is checkmate. Yeah. So alright, so here, instead of b7, let's say you're trying to bring a rook with rook d7. Alright, now queen g6 check, king f2, e4, good move. Right, trying to stop any you know, we just want to check, you know, trying to block, control the f3 square because now the queen want to go f3 to block the check. Alright, and then I mean black's just winning. There's this threat, queen f5 checks, that's a huge threat, and it's actually just checkmate. After queen f5, king g3, h4 is just checkmate. Alright, let's say you play e4 to stop e4 idea. now we have this move, queen c1. So now, after e4 is played, this diagonal is open now. So queen f4 is a huge threat. Queen g5, I guess, also working. Alright, so queen c1, rook f7 to defend queen f4 check. Now king g6, good move, attack the rook. b7, h4, king f2. Alright, king g5 is just checkmate in one. Sorry, checkmate in two. After king f3, we go queen g3 checkmate. So king f2, queen g1 check. King here, and now rook h3. Yeah, and then after you take, queen g3 is just checkmate. Yeah, and then we won the game. So the best defense, right, the best defense is after rook d1. And now we play king g3. Alright, this is the best defense. And right, so the idea is he's trying to play queen g4, right, because there's no check in this position. So you're trying to play queen g4, and the attempt of attack e3 does not come off queen c1 because there's b6, e4, b7, rook e1, b8 queen, you take. Alright, and now there's this good move, rook takes g7, and queen e5, check. Alright, and yeah, so I guess there's a perpetual check here, so white saved the game. So instead of queen c1, right, so wait a second. Alright, so okay, so after king g3, the move is rook h1, rook d7, a takes b5, queen d3 check. Right now after takes, king g6, rook here, rook b1. Rook b1, good move. And you know, maybe black is just better. If you take king f5, and then black is just better. Now we can take this pawn. Alright, so okay, the idea of king g3 is after takes, and then queen g4. Sorry, is it queen g4? Takes and queen g4. Yeah, so that's the idea. So we have this. The right move is just rook h1, alright, and then after rook d7, trying to trade queen, okay, trade the queen, and then this is actually a better rook and pawn endgame. Right, and it's actually difficult for white to defend himself. Right, because I guess black is still winning a pawn here. Alright, so let's see. F takes e3 doesn't work. So let's see, queen takes e3. Right after rook d1 check, king h2. Now, queen b1 is not working. Queen b1 is not working here because now just queen takes e5. Right, now just queen takes e5. After rook h1 check, oh, simply king g3. And there's no useful checks. And in this position, rook d3 also doesn't work because of after queen e2, a takes b5, and now rook f7, good move. Again, they force a trade. Right, and then white has great drawing chances. So in this position, black has to play a takes b5 here. Alright, and white can bring metadals to a rook ending. Alright, in which, notwithstanding the lack of a pawn, he has the right to hope for a draw. So, queen g3 was a good move here. Queen h5 check, queen h3 takes. Queen g6 is worse here because after rook b7. Rook d2, takes, takes, rook takes e5, rook takes b2, and now c4, good move. Alright, but not rook takes e6 because of rook takes g2. Yeah, and now this is actually much, much better endgame for black, you know. You know, because we have two passer. It's like 2 versus 1. And this is actually winning queen and pawn endgame. Going back. Alright, so c4 is the good move in this position. So in this position, we have to trade queen, takes, rook d2, rook e7. Takes, 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 king g6. Yeah. So like I said, in this position, black is up a pawn. He has great winning chances, but maybe this is the best defense of white pieces. Alright, because, yeah. Alright, maybe you can save a draw because, you know, rook and pawn in game is very tricky, but, you know, black is always have great winning chances. Alright. The analysis show that if white is worried about playing the rook endings and decide to hurry with the queen exchange, he'll meet with much more serious problem. So after, right, in this position, let's say you decline the trade. Let's say you play f3. Now it's actually bad because of rook b1. Good move. Right, the idea is currently we want to go rook d2, attack the king, but we can't. So rook d1, b4, now queen h5, queen g6, now rook b2. So that's the idea. Now the rook go to the 7th rank. Sorry, it's the 2nd rank. Yeah, and it's actually just better for black. In fact, I would say it's almost winning for black. Yeah, maybe it's just winning for black. How do you stop this? Queen g1, I guess there's some check here. Right, queen e4, just take with the rook. Alright, so after a takes b5 here. Now, another question. What should black do in answer to rook b7? Alright, so rook b7 actually was what played in the game. It's actually not the correct move. Alright, so alright, they said in this position, right, actually a takes b5 was the best move. Right. A takes b5 was the best move, and e3 was not accurate, but of course, like I say, it's very tricky. So like I said in the start of the game, he said, Dorsky said he do not choose the strongest plan. Alright, so yeah, so actually a takes b5 is just better. Alright, so after e3, takes, check, a takes b5. Okay, so rook b7 was played in the game. Alright, so in this position, there's one good move for black, which is rook d3. Right, queen e2. Alright, queen e2 was a bad move. Alright, so according to the engine, the move here to save the game is g4. Yeah, you counter the queen because you're trying to deflect the queen, and then you take the rook. Queen g6 is the only move. And now you go queen e2. Now you go queen e2. e4, rook takes b5. The idea of rook takes b5, now we want to go rook e5. Let's say rook f3 here, queen takes g4, queen takes e4, takes, takes, takes here. Alright, and this position is actually still better for black. I would say slightly better for black because it's 2 versus 1. But you know, engine say it's a draw actually, but I would say black have great winning chances here. In the game, he played queen e2. Right, g4 is just not human. Not human. This is not e4. g4 is too hard to find. So queen e2. Okay, now Queen e2 loses because of queen f4 check, and then followed by rook d2. So after g3, now we go rook d2 anyway, because you can't move the queen, we take the f2 pawn. You have to trade, now takes. Look at this, we just threatens this pawn, and this pawn. Yeah, so now we're just winning many pawns here. Rook takes b4, it's playing the game. Okay, e takes f4. Right, and simple calculations show that black's pawn will become queens rather more quickly than those of white pawn. Right, so king g2, g5, king f3 is playing the game, rook e1, b4, king g6, rook b8, e5, b5, e4 check, king g2, f3 check. Alright, king here, now rook f1. Alright, e3 was also good, king g3, then we go g4. But okay, rook f1 is very simple move. King g3, now we go check. King h2, if you go king here, right, just simply e3, then we win. So you have to go king h2, but now we go check. And now we just take this pawn, and then we just our pawn is just faster. King h3 is playing the game, and now instead of taking the pawn, black play a move which force white to resign. King h5. And now g4 is just basically checkmate. You have to give up your rook. So in this position, black resigned here. Sorry, I mean white resigned here. I'm sorry. So yeah, because black is just checkmate. There's no escapes for this king. So white resigned, black win. So okay. White resigned. So yeah, so he said in the end of this game, he say it is very important to learn to weigh up objectively or assess intuitively the totality of the competitive and psychological factors. Alright, then we can do what is most unpleasant for the opponent and safest for ourselves. And so gained result that may superficially seems underserved. Right, so basically what he says about this, sorry, so it's about this move, e3. So basically the engine just say that a takes b5 was the best way, you know, and then he say black is winning in this position. Right, so yeah, but they choose e3, which is not the most accurate one, but like I say, so there's one famous quote by Bobby Fischer. He said, I don't believe in psychology, I believe in good move. But I think Kasparov said the opposite one, right? So Kasparov said chess is a human game, so there is psychology. So I don't know what is the quote, but that is the meaning of this quote. So psychology do exist in chess. Yeah, so basically, yes, yeah, so yeah, and in fact, after e3, right, white spent 20 minutes on the clock, so basically, this move do surprise him, right, and he did not analyze this move in his home, you know, because, yeah, I mean, this is an adjourned position that the analyst the game. So basically I would say that white for sure expect a takes b5, you know, but after e3, and then black's winning chances just higher than a takes b5, I guess. Yeah, and then yeah, white didn't find the right defense, the most accurate defense, and then make some mistake, right? Perhaps queen g3 here was the best defense here. Yeah, and then black win the game. Just like that. Alright, so alright, so it's also a very cool game. So that's all for today, I guess. Yeah, and stay tuned. Thanks for watching. Stay tuned for my training days later. So thanks for watching and keep following my road to GM. Yeah, And yes, so bye everyone.